morning students. Now we discuss the topic breathing and exchange of gases. Okay, here in the breathing means taking in of oxygen and releasing of carbon dioxide is called as breathing. And here in them the exchange of gases means oxygen and carbon dioxide gases are exchanged. Means atmospheric air contain oxygen, that air is entered into our body, and carbon dioxide which is formed in our cells, in our tissues, that goes outside. Means here the exchange of gases occurs by the breathing or by the respiration. Okay, here the respiratory system means taking in of oxygen or inspiration, okay, and breathing expiration, breathing out, that is called as respiration. Means taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide, that process is called as respiration. Okay, here it is also called as is a catabolic process of release of energy. Means why it is need respiration? As we take food, okay, that food is digested in digestive system, but how we get the energy? With the help of oxygen only. When that food is mixed with the oxygen, then only we will get the energy. Means by the oxidation of a food, then only we will get the energy. Okay, so it is called as catabolic process. Means metabolism. Metabolism means anabolism and catabolism. Means anabolism means taking in of oxygen and digestion of food, and catabolism means we are getting energy to do work. This whole anabolism and catabolism is called as metabolism. Okay, here respiration is the catabolic process of release of energy. Means by the process of respiration we are getting energy to do work. By the oxidation of food, okay, by the oxidation of food, mixing of oxygen only we are getting energy. Next term, in different animals the different respiratory organs are present. Not all animals respire as same. Here birds, they are aerial birds, means they are present in the air, okay, aerial animals, they respire through the air sacs and parabronchi. Okay, air sacs and parabronchi for continuous exchange of gases during expiration. Means in them always the exchange of gases occurs due to the air sacs. They contain the air sacs. 8 pairs of air sacs are present, and parabronchi means bronchi, they contain so many small tubes, okay, that contain these air sacs. Okay, so parabronchi and air sacs help to continuous exchange of gases in the birds. And next, in insects, okay, in insects like cockroach and mosquito, these and other arthropods also, they supply oxygen directly each cell via trachea. Okay, in them they contain the trachea, means they contain tube like structure, okay, with that is called as trachea. With that they directly respire through that one, and tracheoles, these trachea is the big tube that again divided into small tubes, they are called as tracheoles. Here they are tracheate animals, they respire through the trachea and tracheoles, so they are called as tracheate animals. They are active animals. Among all animals, the birds are the insects are the active animals. Next, it means they can fly anywhere. Next, at height of about 6000 meters, okay, at a height of about 6000 meters, the partial pressure of oxygen, okay, here what is this partial pressure of oxygen directly here becomes almost half of what it is at the sea level. Means they measure with the sea level, okay, at the sea level about means half of the almost half of the what it is at the sea level. Means if it is in this region some amount, here the atmospheric pressure, the height of about 6000 meters, the partial pressure will be half. Okay, so at that area they can means when they go upper side, the partial pressure will be decreased. So that is called as mountain sickness. Okay, that is mountain sickness. They always measure with the sea level. From the sea level they measure. Okay, it is a half means by the height the oxygen level will be decreased. Okay, and next in the mainly rib cage and diaphragm help mammals. In mammals mainly rib cage and diaphragm help to breathe in air more effectively. Means here the rib cage contain the lungs. Okay, that lungs and diaphragm means they help to homeostasis. Okay, homeostasis of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Means homeostasis means leveling of equal parts of oxygen and carbon dioxide is called maintaining of oxygen and carbon dioxide level is called as homeostasis. Okay, here homeostasis of oxygen and carbon dioxide are under the control of respiratory center. Okay, here they are under the control of respiratory center. Here inhalation and exhalation. Inhalation means breathing in. Okay, and exhalation means breathe out. This inhalation and exhalation, they are under the control of medulla oblongata. Where it is medulla oblongata is present? In the brain, it is the brain, and here it contain the brain stem. Okay, in this region that is called as a medulla oblongata, and later this part is called a spinal cord. Okay, here it is the brain, it is the brain stem. At the brain stem, the part, first part is called as medulla oblongata. Okay, these are here the inhalation and means respiration is under the control of medulla oblongata. And next here pneumotoxic center in the pons. Pons means in the brain that contain the pons. Pons part that contain the pneumotoxic center. Okay, that controls the rate and depth of breath. Means how much breathing means what is the oxygen levels that are under the control of pons. Okay. Breathing rate and depth are under the control of pneumotoxic center that are present in the pons. Okay, and next elephant seal that is the mammal. Okay, that is the can remain under the water for up to 2 hours. Means we can't hold our breath for a long time. But here the elephant seal, that is a mammal which is present in the aquatic animal, okay, that can hold the breathing for up to 2 hours, that may remain in the water for 2 hours. Okay, and next, but we can't take the hold of breathing for a long time. And next, elephant seal and other aquatic mammals contains myoglobin. They contain the myoglobin. Okay, that is present in the muscle. Okay, that is the muscle hemoglobin has more affinity for oxygen. Means in them, in elephant seal and in aquatic animals, which are aquatic animals means that which are present in the water, they are called aquatic animals. They contain the myoglobin. Myoglobin means that is present in the muscle. Okay. That is called muscle hemoglobin. We all know that RBC contain hemoglobin, that is the contain the red pigment. But here muscles also contain the hemoglobin. Okay, that is called as myoglobin. RBC contain hemoglobin. Here the muscles contain the myoglobin. Okay, here that they contain the more affinity. Affinity means they can take the more oxygen. Okay. And next, energy is produced by the oxidation of microorganism, micromolecules of digested food, which are we take as food. They are glucose, amino acids and fatty acids. Mainly the main or food items are glucose, proteins, carbohydrates and fats. Okay, here the energy is produced by the oxidation of micromolecules. Means these are carbohydrates and proteins and fats. These are macromolecules that can't absorb directly by the cells. So they are break down into small molecules, that is called digestion. Okay, that these micromolecules, what are they? Carbohydrates are converted into the glucose and proteins are converted into amino acids and fats are converted into fatty acids. These are the small molecules of these food items. Okay, here by the oxidation, when they are mixed with the oxygen, then they will release the energy to do work. Okay, and next, oxygen is utilized by the organisms to break down stored food materials, glucose and fatty acids. Means here mainly the glucose and fatty acids are stored in our body. Okay, that or when oxygen is by the respiration we take oxygen, that mixed with the these glucose and fatty acids, then only formed the oxidation. Now here the process of exchange of oxygen from the medium air and water, means in the presence of air, means some animals they live in water, like terrestrial animals, and some are we mammals and human beings and all aerial birds and insects, they are aerial terrestrial. Okay, they all are in them the exchange of gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide gases exchanged by the medium. These air and water are do the function as a medium. Okay, with the CO2 that is produced by the cells. In the cells the carbon dioxide is formed. Okay, that at the same time is called breathing. Means the atmosphere from the air or water, the oxygen is entered into our body, and the in our body the cells they contain the carbon dioxide that is goes outside. Means exchange of gases occurs at the same time, that is called as breathing. Okay, or it is also called as a process of respiration. During air is inhaled into lungs and exhaled out of lungs. Means inhaling of air and exhaling of air at the same time, that is called as a breathing. Okay. Next, the processes leading to and including the chemical breakdown of food materials to provide energy for life is called as respiration. Okay, what is the meaning of respiration? Means here the inspiration and expiration both occurs. The process leading to and including chemical breakdown means in them the with the help of oxygen they break down the food. Okay, and by the oxidation, that is the chemical breakdown, okay, of food materials to provide energy. They will release the energy for our life. That process is called as a respiration. Means after digestion of our food, when that is mixed with the oxygen, then only by the oxidation, then only they release the energy to do work. Okay, next. Chemical breakdown of the nutrients occurs inside the living cells of every organisms. Means chemical breakdown of nutrients. Means all animals they will take food na, in that the chemical breakdown by the enzymes. They break down by the enzymes or secretions. They break down. Okay. And inside the living cells. In the cells the breakdown will occur. So not in the in the alimentary canal or any cell, any digestive glands, but that is occurs in the living cells, okay, for every of every organism, okay, that is called as internal respiration. Means inside the cells, all organisms are made up of cells, na, these cells, in the cells, they contain the chemical breakdown of nutrients. The nutrients are breakdown into in the cells, that is called as internal respiration or cellular respiration. Okay, do you understand? In the cells means here internal respiration. The external respiration means through the nostrils we are taking air, we are taking oxygen, that is the external respiration. Internal respiration means here in the cells they are breakdown of nutrients is occurring, so it is called as internal respiration or cellular respiration. And next, anaerobic respiration. Two types of respirations are occurs in different animals. What are they? Anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Anaerobic means absence of oxygen. Okay, in the absence of oxygen also respiration will occurs. Okay, like it is the incomplete breakdown of organic molecules. In the absence of oxygen, the breakdown of molecules is incomplete. Okay, so in them they release the less energy, like here yeast, bacteria, and in the muscles they does not contain oxygen, means absence of oxygen, they does not contain oxygen, so even though they respire, that is called as anaerobic respiration, like example yeast, bacteria, and muscles. And aerobic respiration means in the presence of oxygen the respiration occurs. Okay, here the complete breakdown of organic molecules means here the breakdown of molecules is incomplete, but here the complete breakdown will occurs in the aerobic respiration by utilizing oxygen. Means in the aerobic respiration they contain the oxygen, but here they does not contain oxygen, absence of oxygen.